In this video, you will learn the basics of StatCrunch, including calculating basic summary statistics, constructing simple graphs, interacting with those graphs, and copying StatCrunch results into other applications. StatCrunch is a web-based statistical software package for analyzing data that works on any desktop browser, such as Chrome, Firefox, Internet Explorer, or Safari. StatCrunch also works with web browsers on smartphones or tablets, running iOS, Android, and other mobile operating systems. For this video, the data set I'll be using is called Responses to Is College Worth It? This data set contains information collected from a survey conducted at StatCrunch.com. Respondents to the survey were asked if college was worth the cost, with the possible answers being yes, no, or unsure. Respondents also provided their gender, age, and if they were a current college student. All right, now let's perform some basic operations in StatCrunch. The Stat menu contains a number of procedures for summary statistics, tabulation, hypothesis testing, confidence intervals, regression, and much more. With this data set, I'll consider the task of computing summary statistics for the mean and median ages of the respondents. To accomplish this task, under the Stats menu, I'll choose Summary Stats, Columns, and now I'll select the Age column. I'll click Compute, and StatCrunch generates a table of summary statistics. The mean age of respondents is shown to be roughly 29.31, and the median age of respondents is shown much lower at a value of 23. To compute separate summary statistics for each value of gender, back under the Options menu, I'll choose Edit. This takes us back to the original window where we set up our table. Now, under Group By, I'll choose Gender and click Compute. The mean age of female respondents and the mean age of male respondents are both very close to 29.3. The median age of both genders are exactly 23. The Graph menu contains a number of options for displaying data in a variety of formats. To summarize how respondents felt about college being worth the cost, under the Graph menu, I'm going to choose Bar Plot with Data. I'm going to select the Good column, which represents Is College Worth It? And click Compute. In this case, the plot indicates the overwhelming majority of respondents said that college was worth the cost. To break out these responses by gender, I'll go back under the Options menu for the graph, choose Edit, and in the Group By box, choose Gender. I'll click Compute. Now the split bar plot shown splits the original responses coded by gender. Note, the majority of those who answered yes were female. Most graphics in StatCrunch are interactive. This can be a very powerful feature. So for example, to identify the females who said college was worth it, click and drag the mouse to form a rectangle which overlaps that bar. The selected data values are now highlighted in the graph and also highlighted in any other graphs produced. The corresponding rows are also highlighted in the data table. Clicking the down or up buttons in the lower left-hand corner will scroll the data table to show the next or previous selected rows. This is especially useful when there is a small number of rows that have been selected in a large data table. Adjacent to these two arrow buttons, the value of 582 rows indicates how many rows have been selected. To turn off highlighting, I'll click the clear button in the lower left-hand corner of the screen. Both tabular and graphical results can be saved to your My Results listing at StatCrunch.com, or they can be copied, printed, or downloaded. To copy this bar plot, under the Options menu, I can choose Copy. To finish copying the image, follow the tip provided for your platform as shown. After the image is copied, it can be pasted into any other application such as Microsoft Word or PowerPoint. Saving, printing, and downloading are also available under the Options menu of the bar plot window. Copying tabular results is even simpler. Go ahead and click in the window of the table and just use standard keys on that platform to copy the selection, such as Control-C or Command-C. Then use standard paste keys and paste the results into an application such as Microsoft Word.